Kansas just really playing well. They had their best offensive half against the Division I team in that first half.
Jakes with 9, Koch with 7, Oliver with 5. And that's Boshi just inside the line, so he's got 13.
And Ron, he missed his first couple, but boy, yeah, he's shown a great stroke since then.
Well, he's about 5 over his average already. Gregory with 14, Boshi with 13, Chenoweth 6, and Robertson with 5.
And Gregory's going to pick up the foul, but Ron, that's great pressure. They're doing a nice job denying the passes to the wings. And because Iowa can't get the ball to the side of the court, to the wings, they're having a hard time getting it down to their big guys inside, which is why Rucker and Settles have not really had good games thus far.
Lorsman.
And that's a jump ball, and the defense initiated the held ball, and so it now goes to Kansas, and we've got to have the referee stop and make sure they don't reset the arrow. But Settles having a tough time trying to get into the lane. Now,
didn't score, so he moved.
Well, that's right. You take the ball out of bounds underneath the basket.
You have to be stationary.
And it's called a spot throw in because you have to stay on the spot. And Chenoweth ran along the baseline.
And right now, Roy Williams is lecturing to his bench, reiterating that rule so that that mistake doesn't happen again with people who are not in the ball game. And foul on Gregory, by the way, was his first. Boy, Rucker. He wouldn't have hit the ocean with that.
He's having a tough night.
Yep. I'm glad you were prepared for that.
Well, but much like my college days, Ron, I didn't catch it.
0 for 3 is Rucker on the night.
Now, Jess Settles just picked up a foul, Ron, and he looks a little frustrated to me coming out here in the second half. It's 2 fouls now. But right at half court, he felt as if there was a travel, and he's running down the court screaming travel. And so he gets to catch Chenoweth and just gives him the hip. I guess that's okay in hockey, but not here.
You know, Dan Chrisman looks up, and Tom Rucker said, yep, it'll stay that other direction. 2 fouls on that gentleman, Jess Settles.
And Settles, such an outstanding player.
Was 6 years
before he got hurt. And that is a very smart play by Robertson to let the ball bounce over half court before he goes to get it.
Robertson suspends and says, hey, you don't cover me from 14 feet. I can knock this down all night long. 7 for him now.
Who said these guys were struggling on offense?
You know, the scary thing, we were talking during intermission, as the left-hander puts up the running layup and going to be charged with an offensive foul.
Tom Davis calling a 20-second timeout. His team continues to struggle offensively.
Lorsman, 2nd foul on him. It's a 2nd team foul on the Hawkeyes.
It's just very hard to get to the basket against Kansas. You start all the way out on the wing, and you're coming in that far. Somebody's going to be in position. Robertson draws the foul, and he certainly likes it.
They're at 47-34. This is the longest lead of the night. Boshi, we talked about during the intermission. Now, interesting. All of a sudden, he's getting that stroke down. He's averaging just over 8 a ball game. Luke Axtell is transferring. He will be eligible next year. We watched him working out here late this afternoon. If there's Luke sitting on the bench, if, boy, with the stroke he's got, all of a sudden they could turn to totally devastating as far as perimeter shooting for next year. Boshi, turn around, not there. Gregory battles for it, but it's taken away by Lurson. We'll check it, Oliver.
They're just really having a tough time getting guys in scoring position, and you have to credit the Kansas defense for that. Now, Chenoweth is going to pick up the foul, Ron, but that is a perfect example of what I'm talking about. It's hard to throw the ball to the big guy inside from the top of the key. You really need to get it to the wing to do that effectively. Chenoweth trails him across the lane and then gets called because he's got his hand in the middle of his back, and that's 2 fouls.
2nd on him, so he'll come out. T.J. Pugh comes back in. Let me ask you something. What happened to McCausland? He scored the first field goal for Iowa tonight. He hasn't scored since.
I think what happened to McCausland, I'll say the number 4. Ryan Robertson has been all over it.
17 turnovers, Iowa.
Ron, and with McCausland, you know that you've got to cover that three-point shot, but you also know that since 2 games ago was his first trip to the free throw line, he's not going to put it on the floor and take it past it.
It looks like Koch is going to pick up that foul. And that's three on him.
And Koch has been one of the few Iowa inside guys who's been effective today. To emphasize that point on McCausland, this is the 7th game of the season for Iowa. McCausland's only 3 of 4 from the free throw line, so he does not take the ball to the basket very much, and they've done a nice job covering up his three-point attempts, and Bochy's forced to call the timeout.
22nd, that's what they'll take. Well, Saturday at 6 Eastern. From around the nation compete for the 5th Wendy's High School Heisman. The award presented to 1 male and female students based on athletics, GPA, and community service. Then at 7:30 on ESPN, it's the College Football Heisman Trophy presentation hosted by Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Kirk Herbstreit for the famous Downtown Athletic Club in New York City. It's in its 5th consecutive season exclusively on ESPN. Ron Franklin, Dan Bonner coming to you from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, on the campus of KU. 62 straight wins they have here. And in fact, in this half, we'll show you the other folks that trail them as far as consecutive wins at home. Last time they lost non-conference, I did that game. And it was December the 1st, 1993. Been a long time. Missouri beat them in conference play. A couple of years later. Coslin now forcing that shot a little bit because he got a little daylight. And Koch, nice reversal. That's 9. Koch's parents applauding and saying, come on, Hawkeyes, you need to get back in this. They're down by 11, and they do get the turnover.
Bochy now matched up against McCausland. And even when they've allowed him to catch the ball, Ron, they've made him hurry his shot by running at him pretty effectively.
McCausland only averages 7.5 points a game, but he's very effective from the field. A 56% shooter. They battle for that one, and Jakes comes away with it, and a young man we've just been talking about rattles it home. Jake. Jake's now with 12. Gregory. 17 points.
Every time it looks like Iowa's about to put a little run together, Kansas has been able to hit a 3. And now we're going to get a foul on Gregory, hanging on the inside. Game has also gotten a little bit physical. TJ Pugh battling against Jakes, and that is what you call a big-time elbow right there. I don't know that he hit him hard enough to knock him down like that, but Pugh very aggressive on the inside. Jakes is a big guy, too. He must have surprised him. All right, either that or Jakes has a glass jaw. There's another hold, this time against London. Kansas has done a nice job being physical, Ron. This is a team that you wouldn't associate necessarily with physical play. They're not great, big, strong guys, but they have done a nice job being aggressive and physical so far this evening.
Lob pass to Rucker. He had no place to go. He just walked all over the place.
Ron, Rucker has really struggled, and Tom Davis needs that big guy to be effective. It's going to be really hard to come in to a place like Allen Fieldhouse and have a shot in the game if your big guy is playing so poorly.
Settles, prepares to check back in, and the whistle inside.
Well, Pugh got away with it down on one end, but Rucker didn't get away with it down on the other end. Battled against Pugh, and Rucker's going to take and back into him. They're struggling, and there's the elbow. One elbow, that wasn't the foul. The second elbow gets him, though. Rucker got away with it the first time.
That's 14 fouls now on the Hawkeyes. 50-39 as we're about to go under 16 minutes to play in the ball game.
Now, Ron, that is the second time in this game that Pugh has gotten position and received the inbounds pass right underneath the basket. That should never, ever happen. But Pugh just steps into Rucker and then turns around. Now Rucker's on his back and he's stuck. And Settles steps in and picks up the foul trying to help out. And Settles is not a happy young man at this
point. He just walked in there and he picked up his third.
Of course, you would expect Jess Settles coming back after a two-year absence, still plagued by back problems, coming in here with an ankle problem, to struggle a little bit. But I'm telling you, this guy was one of the best, toughest players that I saw in college basketball when he was functioning effectively. And looks like right at the moment, he's just a shadow of what he was.
Hugh gets the second one to go down. As we mentioned, he missed the preseason with a fractured left ankle. He missed 8 games last year because of a stress fracture. And last week he collided with Ryan Robertson and loosened some teeth. So he's had a tough 98 so far. Settles almost lost it. And Lorsman gets the jumper to go down. And that's 4 points for him now. Robertson for 3.
That's a great block out by Settles.
Ring dished it off to Rucker, had no place else to go.
You're right, Ron. He got himself up in the air, realized that he's going to come down with the ball. They're lucky to keep that.
Lorsman to Settles, and that's twice he's been hit with a pass when he was not expecting it. London, great job in the fast break, and credit Ryan Robertson as well. 6 points now for London. Robertson, a nice job of give and go.
Robertson had 6 assists in the first half, Ron, picking up right where he left off. Great defense.
Causes the turnover. 20 turnovers, Iowa. Wanted to get Pugh inside, threw it a little too hard. So this is a break in the action. 53-41, Kansas.
The good old days of supermarket shopping, when nothing stood between you.
53-41 with just over 15 minutes to play in the ball game. So good defensive sequence just a moment ago, particularly by the freshman Bochy.
Well, you know, Kent McCausland is a 3-point shooter, and Bochy trying to stay close to him, and this is a great job. He gets picked off, but look how he gets there before McCausland can shoot. McCausland tries to pass it inside. Now watch as McCausland gets up. Bochy, he's not stopped yet. He gets up right with him and starts covering him again. McCausland, who is an excellent 3-point shooter, led the nation 2 years ago. Tonight, just 5 attempts and only 1 basket. So McCausland has been blanketed. Bochy that time, Ryan Robertson's been doing a great job against him. Kansas rotating guys on him and being very effective.
Bochy out of Valley City, North Dakota. First freshman to start here at KU since Jacques Vaughn. Pretty high company.
You're absolutely right. This great defense. They can't get the ball to the wing, and now you get the big guys passing it around outside, and that results in a turnover.
Here comes Bradford. Nick takes it all the way to the hoop and gets it to go. First 2 points for him tonight.
And Iowa's got to find some answers soon, Ron, or they're in danger of getting just totally blown out of this one.
Range holds up. Not there. The tip by James.
That was great defense inside by Robertson. He forced Range to pull up.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. 22, now 21.
Man to man.
Gregory on Price, and he took it away. Lost the handle. Gregory, or London, I beg your pardon, just reached out and took it away from him.
Price, Ron, actually just fumbled the ball.
Yeah, he did.
Right over to him.
Kansas, 21 points off turnovers.
Well, the interesting thing about it is Kansas has forced 8 turnovers here in the first 6 minutes of this half. Well, Williams troops did a pretty good job forcing turnovers in the first half, but they've really turned it up a notch here in the second.
Well, KU has also doubled them in assists. 16 for the Jayhawks and only 8 for the Hawkeyes. But that's the kind of game, as you pointed out, the kind of game it's been.
Transition type of game. Kansas shooting a high percentage. Because they're playing in transition, they're getting easy opportunities.
Gets it over to Bradford, and he rattles it down.
Outstanding passing, Ron. Just outstanding. And here's McCausland, totally covered up by Gregory. And look at Bradford denying the pass back to Raines. He catches it out by half court.
Raines got away with a couple of jump stops. Oh, my.
Now, let's hope Gregory's okay. He went over. That's press row over there. Went over a couple of those terminals. He's getting up, though. That's the last thing that Kansas needs is another guy hurt. This is the kind of effort that Kansas has been expending all night long. And Gregory gets the ball back inbounds, although he stepped on the line.
Took out the Iowa radio broadcast crew over there.
Run the Hawkeyes. Roy Williams, he's saying, hey, just exactly what was that? The Hawkeyes really having problems hanging onto the ball. Oliver that time had a layup, but he stumbled and dropped the ball. That was a traveling violation against Kansas. And now Iowa can't get it in bounds and calls a 20-second timeout. And that's the last 20-second timeout for Iowa.
Well, subscribe today to ESPN's Full Court College Basketball Package. You'll see hundreds of college basketball games not regularly televised. Over 450 games from top conferences on pay-per-view. Don't miss your favorite team. Call DirecTV at 1-800-GET-SPORTS or PrimeStar at 1-800-PrimeStar.
And that really is a great way to see college basketball, Ron. We've got that at home, and you can just sit there every night and watch all kinds of things.
Well, they're exactly right.
You gotta be kidding.
SportsCenter. Kenny Mayne and Dan Patrick standing by, and that's coming up next. I'm not sure SportsCenter will say go Jayhawks, but
they may after tonight.
Bauer, again, they can't catch the basketball right now. I don't know what that is.
Well, that one was a pass off the ankles. That's a tough one to catch.
Chenoweth off to Gregory. Nice look inside, and the reversal by Bradford. All of a sudden, he's got 6 points.
That's just a great play by Gregory. But again, there's Kansas in transition. They don't wait. They get the ball, and they attack.
McCausland, boy, look.
McCausland has no room at all.
Bradford thought that he had him covered. As we take a look at that last play, Bradford reverses it, comes back underneath and scores, but he just picked up the foul on the other end. 14 fouls against the Jayhawks. Bradford out, carry out. T.J. Pugh is back in the lineup.
And if you're going to press, as Iowa presses, you better do a much better job in transition defense than that. And here's Boshi and Settles getting tied up. And that foul's.
And they call that foul on Boshi. And it was Settles who hit him in a headlock.
Settles got one. Roy Williams saying, hey, he pulled him down.
Well, you'll see it. I mean, he just gets him in a headlock coming up. All right, he's holding him, and then he just wraps his arm around.
There's that. I can't catch it again, Ron.
Taken away, though, by Oliver.
Now, that's a great catch right there. After not catching a fairly easy one, that is a very difficult catch. But that's his first field goal, Ron.
Guy Rucker with his first one, and we have just over 12 minutes to play in the game. 59-43, all KU. Chenoweth at the other end misses a couple of opportunities.
And there Settles going to pick up the foul. Settles has had a frustrating evening. Roy Williams.
They're going to call Oliver.
Oh, they called Oliver. Okay.
First foul on him.
Roy Williams' evening has not been frustrating. To give you some idea of how Iowa has struggled, at halftime, the leading rebounder for the Hawkeyes was Dean Oliver, and he had three. So you know you're in trouble when your point guard is your leading rebounder.
Iowa now 25 turnovers, 5, 11 this half.
Well, they can't run. You're going to turn the ball over when you can't hang on to it. They've had the ball bouncing off hands all night long. And again, they toss it away. And that wasn't an easy catch. That was a difficult catch, but good defense by Kansas.
59-43. Jayhawks having their way on this one. Let's take a break. We'll be right back. More from Lawrence, Kansas coming up.
Live to run? Get the wired running shoe and all the latest athletic wear from Adidas at Champ Sports.
Is the moment we've planned. Meet the new face of evil. Eliminate them. On December 11th, the ultimate battle begins.
Lock and load.
Star Trek Insurrection, rated PG. December 11th, only in theaters.
For Dodge Intrepid, we look beyond a great look and took cab-forward architecture to a new place. With a spacious cabin, a very useful pass-through, and a cavernous trunk, Intrepid is an automobile for today, wrapped in a shape for the next millennium. Well-equipped for as low as $20,495.
My Aunt Leona called. She was throwing a party and she sprung a leak.
Meet the man who didn't send the money, Western Union.
I figured, what difference could it make, huh?
And the heartbreak it caused. Later tonight.
Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
59-43, just under 12 to play.
Ron, the Kansas guards got criticized a little bit, beat up a little bit in that grade eight. But they have played very well tonight. Bochy with the steal there. Bochy with a nice three-point basket right here. Ryan Robertson has also played very well defensively, taking the charge. And then offensively, he's done a great job leading this fast break here scoring, but he's got 7 assists on the evening. There you go. That's what it looks like tonight.
Yeah, it sure does. That could turn into a really nice combination here in 98-99 for the Jayhawks. Foul trouble. Settles for 3 and Koch with 3 for Iowa. And Bochy has 3 for Kansas. Gregory misses on the long three-pointer.
Well, Iowa's got to get something done on the offensive end. And they're in transition. Iowa has suffered in transition, but they score right there.
Rucker has 6. Gregory, by the way, is still 8 of 10 on the night. That's not bad. TJ Pugh. TJ's been unlucky. He's been in tight, just looking at it, and has either not been able to get it off or been unfortunate with the shot.
Well, he had great position on the inside, and they're now starting to attack Rucker in there a little bit.
Gregor
and man for Kansas.
Oliver throws it off the leg of TJ Pugh.
Ron, we've talked about Pugh and his being able to get position all night long. That's just a great job getting position inside against Rucker. They're very fortunate, as Iowa is, that Pugh didn't score because he created a great opportunity for himself.
Duez Henderson into the lineup, freshman out of Detroit, 6'7", and he was the one that the crowd was oohing and aahing about because they thought that he had thrown an elbow. And Rucker, all of a sudden, now is in double figures. Oh, 8, beg your pardon. And that's going to be stolen by Bauer. Oliver for 3, and he got it.
We got a ball game again, Ron.
Gregory, spin move.
Gregory has played so well in transition tonight, and he did a great job attacking Rucker.
Lursman now with 3 fouls. Coslin prepares to check back into the lineup, as does Koch.
know that Gregory, as he misses that one badly, shoots the ball well enough to be an effective perimeter shooter in a half-court type of game. But you let him get involved in one of these transition games, and his skills really come to the fore. He has been outstanding this evening.
Tell you what, he's 0 of 3 from the line, but he's 8 of 10 from the field with 17 points. And the beautiful thing I know that the coaching staff at Kansas is enjoying about his efforts, and that gives him 18, is his average coming into this ball game was 13.6. That's like double what he had last year. So he has lifted his game considerably, as the foul against Iowa's going to be against Oliver, his second.
Right, it's another turnover. They take the ball away again, and that's a foul on Oliver, and Kansas is going to get to go to the free throw line. Oliver trying to push it again. The ball just bounces away from him. Now Bochy's in great position, putting on great pressure, but Bochy never got his hand on the ball, and Bradford picks it up. That's a good job by Bochy. We showed you before the job he was doing against McCausland. That time he's guarding the dribbler, forces a turnover.
19 fouls. Bradford, a 60% free throw shooter, swishes that one.
Ron, and Iowa drew within 9, and then they gave up a foul to Gregory in that transition situation, which they've struggled with all evening, and then they give up a turnover, and Bradford now scores.
And this is on that one. Range will come away with a rebound for Iowa. About to go under 10 minutes to play. Koch threw it away, and they say it was touched last by Kansas.
That's a real break for Iowa. Look at this. Look at this defense.
Henderson.
And he's going to get pushed from
Nick
behind.
Bradford pushed him from behind to get the foul.
I think one of the points that Tom Davis has been trying to make with the officials is that they really have to call fouls in these situations because Kansas is so aggressive. There's no one for Range to throw the ball. And finally, Henderson comes over, and Bradford, it's not much of a push, but he does push him from behind. It's been a frustrating evening for Tom Davis.
Duez Henderson. 3 fouls on Bradford, by the way. And 17 fouls against Kansas. So Bradford goes in that list of foul trouble. He and Bochy both with 3.
Now, if he makes this run, let's see if Iowa goes to the press. Well, good point.
Blocked by Chenoweth. And they still get the putback. Range with his first 2. Robertson at the other end, dishes it off to Gregory. Missed, and Robertson on the foul.
Ron, Iowa has only stopped him once or twice in the press all night. That is a long shot. You can't be serious.
Koch, if he's any further out, he's got to buy a ticket. Wow. Oh. Bradford is called for the offensive foul. 4 now on him.
Koch did a nice job, Ron. He missed that long, long-range shot, but he got back on defense and made up for it with a real nice play on that end. Koch right at the bottom of your screen, turns number 44 in black, just turns into him. He's got his feet set. He's got his position established. Bradford can't run into him. You know, this Iowa team, they may be a better shooting team than they were last year, but with their losses, they're not nearly as athletic, Ron, and you've really seen that tonight with their inability to press Kansas effectively. They didn't do very well in that alley-oop either.
No, they didn't. Here's Bochy. London, as you can see, back in the lineup, number 24. Freshman out of Broadview, Illinois. And that foul's going to be on Henderson, who is down on the floor. Getting up quickly is Jeff Carey, the 6'9 and a half redshirt freshman of Camdenton, Missouri.
Jayhawks doing a nice job. They're big guys in the half-court offense in the second half, getting position.
These two coaches have substituted so much that it's been Kind of like a hockey game, five over the boards at a time.
You know, Ron, interestingly enough, we talked about the game that Gregory has had and how the transition has really helped his production this evening. Well, Chenoweth, on the other hand, even though he runs the court very well, he has not had very many opportunities to set up.
KU was only 4 of 12 from the free throw line.
Wow.
And interestingly enough, Iowa 9 of 12 in the first half. They only have made one in the second half. Another reason they've fallen behind by 10.
Kansas has done a nice job creating turnovers on the perimeter just like that, and there's a foul. They're going to rule that an intentional foul, I think.
Well, London almost got undressed. He almost took his jersey off right here in front of us. That's 29 turnovers.
Well, now, Range has the basketball. He squares up, and London just takes it from him, and Range, reaching for the ball, grabs him by the shirt. And I originally thought that Tom Rucker had crossed his arms and called an intentional foul, but he had not. See, what's happening, Ron, is Iowa isn't forcing the fouls because they're turning it over out on the perimeter. They never have the chance to get it inside, and they're picking up the fouls because they're trying to stop Kansas running down the court. That having been said, as they miss another free throw, this is still just a 10-point game, Ron. Iowa's still in it.
So KU's shooting woes at the free throw line continue. 4 of 14 as Chenoweth comes out, and Carey checks back into the lineup.
Ron, they've shot the ball better from three-point range. They're of 14.
They have. Well, maybe
they ought to move back.
Back up for the free. Oh, boy.
That is a big time play right there, Ron. Tough defense, a big time play.
Oliver knocks it down, and he now has a total of 10 points in double figures as we hit the 8:32 mark.
Here's another foul. Again, Kansas, Ron, they've done such a good job. They beat the press, and then they run the ball down the court where they get an advantage situation. And in transition, Rucker not doing a very good job getting in position. Carey just gives him the fake and draws the foul. That is not a good job by Rucker. A little bit lazy, I think, on the end of that fast break.
Two fouls on Rucker. And the crowd reacting to the fact that they made a free throw. Roy kind of stone-faced is that one.
Well, they made two.
They made
get
two
a big
the
roll.
All the kids are standing down here to the left. Oh, boy. Well. 11-point lead, Kansas, as we're about to go under 8 minutes to play.
Oh, he banked that in.
Call
and
that
no.
One. McCausland made the first hoop of the night.
Now, let's see who they're going to call what. The Pugh and Jakes got tangled up. And they're not going to call anything. They're just going to tell him to settle down. That's
what I was going to say is McCausland scored the first three-pointer of the night and has just now scored with just barely over 8 minutes to play. They've been all over him.
And that was great defense. There's no way he was planning to bank that baby. But they're back within eight, Ron. When Jakes, keep an eye on Jakes and Pugh. That might be something that develops.
London. Range way outside.
Boy, that's a big three-point basket. We got a five-point game, Ron.
Robertson. Hangs, can't get it to go, and as they battle inside, we've got bodies all over the place.
And that is a possession arrow call. So it's the alternating possession on the held ball.
Sheldon's a timeout, and we'll take it with him. 7:25 left in the game, and all of a sudden, here come the Hawkeyes back. 66-61, five-point game.
This week on the Johnny Carson Show, Judge Wapner holds court.
I object.
Well, don't object. It's not going to help you any.
David Letterman makes his case.
You know, a couple of weeks ago, we found out that there was going to be an opening on the Supreme Court, and I think myself and the rest of America just naturally assumed you'd be going to Washington.
Don't miss the Johnny Carson Show, now playing on Channel 198, only on DirecTV.
Sessions at West 54th, the highly acclaimed music performance series returns to public television, hosted by David Byrne. Now, DirecTV brings you musical previews and exclusive, intimate interviews from the series. Sessions at West 54th, weekends on your local public television station. Sessions preview on Channel 500, only on DirecTV. This week, Desiree, John Hyatt, and Lyle Lovett.
The New York Jets, the Miami Dolphins on ESPN Sunday Night Football.
Here's to the man who brought back the old Jets unit.
Who the heck are you?
This is my cousin from Kentucky.
Raymond McKinney, nice to meet you.
Well, you're stuck in the past, McKinney!
Oh, come on, man, those are a classic design.
You're a classic nincompoop!
I'll tell you what's stuck in the past. The word nincompoop. Very old.
ESPN Sunday Night Football, the Jets against the Dolphins.
Go Jets.
Bill Pito in the studio, 17th-ranked Washington, having its hands full early here with Gonzaga. Richard Fromm here for Gonzaga will nail the jumper in the first half. Gonzaga leads it by 500 minutes to go in the first half, Ron.
Well, 66-61. And moments ago, here's some of the action underneath. Mr. Coslin banking in the three.
Well, and Pugh and Jakes are tied up there. And
Jakes could have been called for a technical. He was impeding him from getting the ball and kept kicking it out of bounds.
Now I think Pugh's going to pick up the foul. Ron, you're right about that.
Here's the story if you just joined us. Iowa led once, 3-2. They trail by as many as 18, 59-41. Now trail by only five, and that's in spite of committing 29 turnovers.
But one of the big keys, Ron, is Kansas is only 7 of 17 from the free throw line. And that has really hurt the Jayhawks.
Jake scores, TJ Pugh.